Truex Jr. No! Trouble!
Oh, that's going to turn Truex. And Truex is going to get right into Burton, and we've got more problems.
We've got all kinds of people. Kevin Harvick.
Brian Vickers. David Ragan. Casey Mears is involved in that. Oh, what a mess for the eighth caution of the day.
Lots of RCR cars sitting in that shot.
And there's one of them right there.
I think
Kevin
all three RCR cars got in it.
Yeah.
Harvick, Burton,
we didn't
and
see
Casey Mears. Oh, yeah, Boyer was not in it.
And I'm going to tell you, Truex was a factor. This was a guy that had a shot at running in the top five and possibly putting himself in position to win the race. These guys were good today.
I'm curious to see if it all checked up and just was
Watch the 88.
Okay, the 88 got sideways.
And he's got Truex right behind him.
Kyle Busch.
But
Kyle couldn't really go anywhere.
No.
So
Rudiman gets turned.
I think the 88 looked like he got a little bit sideways. Let's listen. That's already happened, I think, by this point.
Yeah, it's behind that, isn't it?
That was just one of those chain reaction deals. Kyle Busch was already up close to whoever he was next to. You see him down on the bottom. You see the one has to check up. Kyle tries to squeeze to the right. Whether Martin came over or whatever, there just wasn't enough room. Doesn't really matter. I mean, it's just everybody going for the same spot.
And you know, when the 88 spun his tires, he goes to the inside. So now all of a sudden it looks to Kyle Busch like it's a three-wide racetrack. You see the 88. Look at how far over he comes over. You can't see it from that angle. But the 88 or the 18 stuffs it up in there, and the one follows and then comes back to get around the 88.
Yeah.
And there's no place to go. That is strictly racing. And I know everybody, what's the 88? Well, we're already past it again. They're already into it.
It's just, like I said, it's just a chain reaction thing where you're only talking about inches here.
Yeah, and that's
nobody's
fault.
You don't have a lot of room to work with. When somebody checks up in front of you, you're just hoping you don't get run over, and you're looking for real estate to try to get out of the way.
Yeah, watch this from inside the six car. Look, this is brake smoke right here, and he still gets in the back of the 83. Boom, there he is. All of a sudden, the 83 goes by, the 83's in it also. But, I mean, think about this. Think about when you're sitting at a stoplight, and this is a 31. 31 goes inside. He thinks he's clear. Boom. He runs right into the one car, and you can't see it. Golly.
Man.
That's a wicked hit right there, man.
When you hear that, that's a shot.
They just started wrecking up in front of us, and, you know, I tried to slow down as much as I could and just wound up right in the middle of it. But I just got to thank all these guys in the Shell Pennzoil Chevrolet. We got our car going really good, and we're starting to make good ground there. And I think we're up to 14th or 15th, and kind of typical of the year. So it's been a tough year, but we'll keep at it.
Oh, Martin, happy with Kyle Busch.
And he's not happy, but I think when he goes and looks at it, he'll realize exactly what happened. Look, we've all been in that position where you think the guy behind you run over you, you run into the guy in front of you, or whatever, but it's not that way. I think when you look at it and you take it back, it's not anybody's fault.
You know, I'm not sure what happened in front of us, the 88 or the 2, spun the tires. I think it was, I'm not sure who it was, but I was just, you know, staying in line, doing what I could do to get going. You're not, you know, you obviously can't pass before the start-finish line, and I guess Kyle just decided he didn't want to lift, so, you know, just an innocent victim today.
You pulled back on the helmet throwing. It's a little more frustrating when you have a car that good.
Yeah. We've had a tough season, you know. It's been tough, and this don't help much.
A lot of times when you have a car that you feel like can win the race, makes it a little more difficult to swallow, doesn't it, guys?
Yeah, it does, Marty, and this was a place he was really looking forward to a good run. Martin has finished in the top 10 in the last four races here at New Hampshire Motor Speedway.